Hello everyone and welcome to today's Instagram live session. Today we are going to talk about knee joint. I got some request in the last session that if we can have a session on knee joint. So that's the reason I have selected knee joint as a topic for today. And we'll be talking about knee joint. What are the problems that we face at different age group when it comes to knee problems? When is the right time to see a doctor? What kind of food habits can actually make your knee better or probably even worse? What kind of exercises you're supposed to do in case of knee problem, and what exercises are you not supposed to do? And when does surgery has a role to play in different age groups? This is all what we're going to cover in this session. And before we start off the session, I would like to invite you all and thank you so much for joining in. For all the people who are watching us live, thank you so much for joining in, whether you're watching us on Instagram or Facebook or on YouTube. Thank you for joining in. And I have already received a few questions regarding doubts that they have, which I'll be clearing off at the end of the session. So talking about knee joint, knee joint is a hinge kind of joint, which is basically, you know, it's like a door which opens only to a certain extent, you know, so the movement happens only this much, you know, this is how the movement happens. It's not a ball and socket or a hip joint or a shoulder joint where the movement will happen in probably 360 degree and in all directions. So the movement happens in preferably only in one direction. This is what you have it, you know. There are definitely rotation movements also involved, but yes, primarily the movement is knee flexion and extension. And this is one reason the knee is susceptible to more problems, or because of the weight bearing, first thing, and secondly because its stability is a lot more dependent on ligaments, and it is also dependent on a lot of meniscal, the whole component or the structure of the knee joint. So yes, Karthik, please go ahead and put in your question. I will definitely answer your question at the end of the session. So based on the structure of the knee joint, you tend to have different problems at different age groups. Primarily, you will have four reasons when you will actually have problems related to knee joint. Now, this could be meniscal or ligament tears. Secondly, you will have issues because of knee stiffness or knee arthritis, and then you will have something called the chondromalacia patella or the jumper's knee or the patellofemoral syndrome, which is one of the commonest thing with knee. We have a lot of people joining in, and I'm glad to have you all from Heart, Joint, Karthik, Freak Fit, Ashish, Abhilash Nair, Siddiqui Lover, Mary, Karthik again, Anaga, Rahul Kul, Sachin. Karthik, I want to finish this topic first and then I will take your problem live. So let me finish up with this topic because there are already a lot of people watching in. So let me finish up the knee joint topic that we have taken for today. Once we are done with this, I will certainly come to you on live. Okay. And yes, so talking about knee joint, like I told you, the structure is such that the movement is only in one direction because of its weight bearing, you have to constantly walk and you have to put a whole lot of your weight on the knee, it is susceptible to more problems. And the problems that we normally notice is basically chondromalacia patella or patellofemoral syndrome, which also happens with runners, meniscal and ligament injuries, frank injuries, which could be because of a sports injury, and ultimately knee arthritis. So meniscal and ligament injuries essentially happen in young ages. Normally before 40 is where you can see these things happening more commonly. Football players and a lot of other sports also, which can actually lead to these kind of injuries. Not in all cases is that you need to, you know, undergo a surgery as the only option. Most of the cases can actually be solved by physiotherapy also, and it's only when you have a grade 3 tear or a complete tear of your menisci or your cruciate ligaments is where you have to actually undergo a surgery, and you have some of the finest surgeons, and the surgery is absolutely safe, yes, but it has to follow with a proper physiotherapy schedule, because that also plays a very important role after your surgery. We have to ensure that you attain a proper rehabilitation. So talking about when do you really show, or when do you show it to a doctor when you have a knee problem? Is it only just pain, or what could be the other symptoms on which you should actually show to a knee doctor? So the first thing is, you should look at if your knee is really swollen very badly, and if you can see that there is a lot of redness in your knee, then yes, you should be actually going in to see a doctor. Besides that, if you see that there is any stability issue, like, you know, in whatever age you are, if you feel that you're not able to put proper weight on your knees, or if you feel that there are stability issues, then it is the time to see a doctor. Also, if you see that there are deformity issues, like, you know, your knee is changing, you know, it's changing the shape, it's looking more like a bow knee, or it is looking like a knock knee. Now, in these cases also, you need to see a doctor, because your knee is gradually getting deformed. It is gradually getting used to the kind of weight bearing you are putting on it, and because of it, these are the secondary changes which are happening with the knee. And in this case, it's very, very important that you show it to a doctor. And yes, it is also very, very crucial to understand that if you have an unstable knee, which is when, you know, while walking, if you feel that there is your knee just pops out, or your knee just gives away the weight, then is the time that you need to see a doctor, because it clearly shows that you have a ligament laxity problem, and this has to be seen by an orthopedician or a relevant doctor related to this whole problem, and who can actually guide you for all of this. Now comes the question as to what kind of role physiotherapy has to play. Well, most of the cases, physiotherapy plays a very crucial role, whether it is ligament injuries, whether it is meniscal injuries, whether it is arthritis, whether it is osteoarthritis, whether it is rheumatoid arthritis, or for that matter, even patellofemoral syndrome or chondromalacia patella. It definitely plays a very important role in physiotherapy, where, you know, all kind of rehab or probably pain relieving modalities are used in order to ensure that the treatment goes very well. So I see a lot of patients who keep telling me that, you know, I had a surgery at some point of time, and after that I cannot get back to my normal routine, or I don't feel that, you know, I'm not confident enough to get back to this whole thing, and I feel, you know, my whole movements are restricted to a great extent. Well, if you have undergone a surgery, it has to be followed by a proper rehab, and yes, you can get back to all your activities. It's not like, you know, if you have a meniscal or a ligament surgery, it's not like you are restricted to certain movements, because these are all corrective surgeries, and they ensure that your movements also get back. Yes, with knee replacement surgeries, which happens with total knee replacement in severe arthritis patient, you do have certain kind of limitations, but these days the kind of implants that are used, and definitely helps you to kind of give you a complete movement in total knee replacements also. So ultimately the overall results are very, very productive. So talking about food, have you ever thought that certain kind of foods can also make a difference to the way you prove nourishment to your knees? So that's actually true, that there are a few list of foods that are actually required in order to ensure that you have a healthy knee, which essentially includes omega-3 fatty acids. It also includes nuts and seeds that you should be using, all kind of nuts like walnut, and basically everything that has healthy fats in it. Almonds, chia seeds are also very good for your knee health. Besides that, you should also be having colorful fruits, different kinds of fruits, because that can also help you to have a very good knee health. Olive oil is definitely very good for your knee, and even whole grains are certainly helpful in order to gain or improve your health on the knee. Now, how do we really prevent these problems? Like, okay, once you have the problem, you know that you have to go to a doctor, you have to go to a physiotherapist and get this solved. But how can you prevent your problem with this knee? So one is your eating habit. And secondly, you need to basically look into reducing your weight, because if you have a higher weight, there are chances that you will be having more problems related to the knee. Secondly, you should also look at having 30 minutes of exercise, a minimum of 30 minutes of exercise for your overall body, so that you know, your knee also keeps up in the normal range of motion. At the same time, you can also ensure that any amount of weight which is within you can actually start losing onto your weight. One question that I have seen coming up with a lot of my patients is, you know, what kind of exercises are relevant for knee problems? Like, you know, what exercise should be done and what exercises should be not done? Because there are different school of thoughts which talks about these exercises, that this can be done and this cannot be done. So I have a clarity on that for you. And I have come up with a list of exercises which you should be doing for knee problems and a list of exercises which you should definitely not do for your knee problems. So let me talk about what exercises are effective for the knee. Firstly, water aerobics is the best form of exercise that you can do for your knee, because when you do any sort of exercise in water, it basically helps to get that weight completely off, and you are actually working out on your muscles. So that's the best form of environment you can give for your knee. Secondly, you can get into cycling. Cycling is again a good form of exercise for the knee, as long as you are having the right kind of seat height, because of which you are not getting into excessive knee bending or excessive knee extension. So that is something which you need to take care of. Besides this, basic exercises like normal squats, lunges, even hamstring curls, leg press, if you're doing these exercises in a gym, it is equally effective. Now coming to what exercises you should not be doing. So it's very, very important that you should not do exercises with knee extensions with weights, because that tends to put a lot of pressure on the undersurface of the patella, and that is something which is not advisable. Besides that, you should also avoid deep squats or deep lunges if you have knee problems. If you have been witnessing knee pain, you should definitely deep lunges. So these are the exercises that you need to avoid when it comes to knee issues. So talking about, a lot of people also ask me that, you know, when we have ligament issues or when we have knee pain, is exercise really relevant for it? Should we really go ahead and exercise? So my answer here is yes, you should exercise, because most of the time when you actually exercise in these conditions, you are giving the right kind of movement, you're giving the right kind of nourishment which is required for your knee to become a little more lubricant, for your knee to become a little more mobile. So yes, basic form of exercise like, you know, SLR, side movements, or even basic squats, all these exercises are definitely helpful, as long as you're not in acute pain. One more thing that I want to cover here is that when to use a heat and cold therapy when it comes to knee. So basically, if you have issues which are related to sports injuries, or if you have a pain which has just started and you have never noticed this kind of pain, which means it is an acute pain, at that point of time, icing is a good solution. Second situation is when you know that you have knee joint problem, which is essentially like a arthritis, or you have issues which are, you know, related to knee, and you have been doing this for a long time and it is more like a chronic knee. In these cases, heat therapy works well, because in heat therapy will actually help you to you know, kind of make your muscles a little more soft and improve the blood circulation, and also help you to improve the joint mobility. Besides that, icing will basically help you to reduce inflammation, which is required in sports injuries, which is required in acute injuries. So this is all about the knee, where I have discussed with you when do you need to see a doctor, what are the different conditions in which you have knee problems, heat and cold therapy, when is it relevant, and also the food habits, what kind of food can actually help you to, you know, kind of improve your knee. So there are some questions coming up. Hi Mahesh, Ravi, Srina, Vicky, Jain, music is my life, Avi 1935, Nandini, Manish, Partunga, 90 Owl, Raju Yadav, Karma Fit Art, Dr. Jagannathan, Nighty Owl, Physio Apurva Kadam, Swapnil, Mishra Bhavna. Sachin Randeve has a question. I had an ACL replacement done in March 2017. My knee hurts a lot while walking or climbing stairs. I have done a lot of tests and reports and all seems to be normal. Please advise. Sachin Randeve, we really need to see what kind of implant was used for your knee. Does that implant has a limited amount of range of motion, and if you're pushing really more than that, probably this could be an issue. If your replacement is done in 2017, so that's not very far, and I'm sure you're using the best of implants, but in case if there are limitations in your implants, there could be an issue related to your range of movement. Or if there is any amount of knee stiffness, which is where your knee is not straightening up completely, there is a little bit of bend still there, because when we are into total knee replacements, a lot of time patients finish up the replacement but they don't follow up with physiotherapy. They feel that since the implant is already set in the body, everything will happen fine. There are some orthopedicians who definitely believe that physiotherapy is required post knee replacement, but few of them feel that this may not be relevant and the patient will start walking on its own. Patient does walk, there is no doubt about it, but sometimes they walk with a flexed knee, where they are very scared to put weight on the knee, because of which they bend the knee a little bit and walk like that. Now when they walk in this manner for a very long time, that's how they tend to get the same kind of walking which they had before the surgery. And correcting that whole thing after surgery, after 1 month or 2 months after surgery, is a very difficult task. So this should happen immediately after the surgery is done. So that really helps you to get proper results. Mahesh Gide has a question. Mujhe disc bulge hai lower back mein. Mahesh Gide, disc bulge aapka डायग्नोसिस है, आप मुझे बताइए आपका प्रॉब्लम क्या है. अगर आप ओवरवेट हैं, अगर आपकी फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी में इशू है, तो इसके वजह से आपके कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स होंगे. तो आप मुझे बताइए कि आपके प्रॉब्लम्स क्या हैं. ये हम अगर अपने डायग्नोसिस को अपने सर पर रखकर चलेंगे और सोचेंगे कि अब यही डायग्नोसिस डिसाइड करेगा कि हमारा प्रॉब्लम या हमारा प्रॉब्लम कैसे सॉल्व होना चाहिए, ऐसा नहीं होता है. ये एक साइकोलॉजिकल इशू हो जाता है. जस्ट बिकॉज आपके पास एक MRI रिपोर्ट आ गई है और आपको पता चल गया है कि ये MRI में ये चीज़ मेंशन है, तो आपको डिस्क बल्ज है L4 L5 लेवल पर. काफ़ी सारे पेशेंट्स मेरे पास आते हैं जिनका प्रॉब्लम L4 L5 लेवल पर है, वो कभी कंप्लेन नहीं करते उसके बारे में, क्योंकि प्रॉब्लम कहीं और होता है, फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी कहीं और होती है. तो ये चीज़ को हमें समझना बहुत ज़रूरी है और इसीलिए इसको पूरी तरह क्लियर करना बहुत ज़रूरी है. ठीक है, एक क्वेश्चन था मुझे, मैंने एक पोस्ट स्टोरी शेयर की थी और उसमें मुझे तीन चार क्वेश्चंस आए थे. तो उसमें से एक क्वेश्चन था कि क्या एंटीरियर, कैन वी करेक्ट एंटीरियर पेल्विक टिल्ट, कैन एंटीरियर पेल्विक टिल्ट बी करेक्टेड विथ स्पाइनल मैनिपुलेशंस. सो माई आंसर इज येस, इट कैन बी करेक्टेड. डेफिनेटली इट्स नॉट जस्ट वन सेशन दैट विल हेल्प यू टू गेट योर एंटीरियर पेल्विक टिल्ट करेक्टेड, बिकॉज वंस यू आर इन एंटीरियर पेल्विक टिल्ट, इट ऑल्सो हैज़ अ लॉट ऑफ कॉम्पनसेशन कमिंग फ्रॉम द लंबर स्पाइन एंड द सेक्रम. सो इट टेक्स टाइम फॉर यू टू काइंड ऑफ गेट दिस एडजस्टेड. एट द सेम टाइम अ प्रॉपर एक्सरसाइज थेरेपी नीड्स टू बी फॉलोड. वन मोर क्वेश्चन दैट आई हैड वॉज, I have a lot of stiffness in my neck and that has now moved on to my temporomandibular joint. So can you show me some exercises? Regarding exercises, I will not be able to show you the exercises right away, because before doing that, I need to examine the whole thing and understand if you are ready for exercises, or probably before that, we need to get into some sort of therapy, maybe some sort of TMJ manipulations or mobilizations. And I will strongly suggest you to see a specialist also, who can help you out if there is a TMJ issue. In certain conditions, cervical spond, when it becomes severe, it can involve the movements of your jaw and it can become a little stiff. So that is a possibility. So you need to check onto that and understand how it can be done. Dr. Gajanan Thane. He has a question. Knee buckling kabhi kabhi hota hai. What is the reason? Not yet investigated. Not that troubling, but concerned why it happens. Knee buckling can happen for two or three reasons. One of the reasons could be a weak knee. Okay, so if you have a weak knee, there are chances that you can buckle more frequently. अगर आपके ligament issues हैं या meniscal issues हैं तो इसमें भी knee buckling हो सकता है. तो अगर ये frequency बहुत ज़्यादा बार होने लगी है तो yes, you need to consult an orthopedician or you need to consult a physiotherapist who can check and who can let you know how we can take this therapy ahead. Yogananda Kumar, any quick fix for plantar fasciitis? Quick fix is start wearing footwear at your home if you're not doing that at all. Okay, before you step out of the bed early morning, make some movements of your ankle in all directions. Take 5 minutes to move your ankle in all directions and only then step onto the floor, because plantar fasciitis essentially happens early morning. The pain is essentially when you're resting for a very long time and then trying to walk. So what happens is that the area becomes completely sore because of inflammation. So what you need to do is that you need to renew the blood supply. You need to actually move the ankle a little so that you're renewing the blood supply. Once you start doing that, the pain settles down quite a bit. And then yes, you need to also stretch your plantar fascia, which is easy ways walking on toes as a practice in order to stretch your plantar fascia. Once you feel that stretch, once you start working on those stretches, the pain reduces drastically. So thank you so much guys for joining in for this knee session, and I hope I have answered to all your questions. And I had some questions from my story also, and which I have answered. And yes, hope you like this session. Do leave in a comment in the section below, and I will see you next week again on our Instagram live session. You can again leave a comment if there is any specific topic that you want me to cover or come up with your questions that I can help you out with. Thank you so much, and stay safe. We are again in the lockdown period, and stay safe, stay home, and stay healthy. Thank you so much.